Hey, it's Patti Scharf, CPA and co-founder of Catching Clouds, the leader in e-commerce accounting. And today I'm continuing my series on helpful tools for e-commerce sellers. This time I'm going to be talking about Asana. And it's not really unique to e-commerce sellers. It's more just helpful for anybody who has a business. So let's jump in and talk about that. All right, so before we used Asana, we were using, I think, Toodledoo is what it was called. And it was great, it was cheap, and it was good for managing just individual tasks for two or three people. Once we got to like four or five people, it started to not work very well. And I'm super happy that we found Asana. So I think we've been using this since, had to have been 2014. So we've been using it a long time. And I'm not going to give you like a full-blown demo, but I'm going to show you a few things that I think are pretty cool about it. So Asana is a project management tool. It's a to-do list. It's helpful for keeping track of other people's work and your own work. So if you're trying to actually hire some people to help you out in the warehouse or just wherever to help take some of the burden off of you as the business owner and just delegate some tasks, I think it's got some really great features that are helpful for you. So this program is really powerful, so I don't even really know where to start. But typically I will start in my inbox. If you are following somebody else's task and they like mark it as done, poof, it pops up in your inbox. But I pretty much live in this thing called My Tasks, where it keeps track of all of my tasks. And one of the things that I like a lot about it is it will automatically, if you put a date, a due date in there, it will automatically recognize when you're a week out and it'll put it in your upcoming tasks. I'm a little busy. I got a lot of tasks going on every week, but it'll automatically bump it up there. You can create like headings just kind of on the fly just by putting a colon behind it so that you can keep things nice and organized. You can label things. So like we've got different teams. We've got our clients and all the teams related to that. And you can see all the people who work for us are all on that team. So we can invite just specific members of our team to one particular team is what it's called in here. So like we've got one section just for like me and Scott, another one for just me, another one for our whole team, another one for just a few members of the team. It's really flexible. And then in each project, you can have a list of different topics or tasks and things like that. You can assign them to different people. You can include different due dates. One of the things that I think is super cool is this new thing that they added called Add Custom Fields. So I created this new field called Stage. And when I click on Stage up here, it will automatically sort what I'm working on based on what that stage is. So in my case, as a business owner, I am looking to delegate tasks that I'm not supposed to be working on. I'm looking to automate different tasks that I'm not supposed to be working on. And then there may be some tasks that only I can do. I can't delegate them just because they're unique to me. Or maybe there are things that are just my zone of genius that I should be doing that stuff. So I think that's really cool. You can also just click on the little assignee up here and it'll group it by who owns the task. So that's really great for if you're managing somebody, you're working on a project and this person's working on that and that person's working on that and this person's working on this other thing. You can sort it by assignee and then you can see where everybody is in their progress on that project. Okay. And then you can change the view over here. You can sort it by due date or whatever. So it's pretty cool. There are just a couple other things I want to show you. Like they've got this calendar view. So if you have all your tasks and due dates and things like that, and you want to see it in a different view, you can do it like that. You can like have conversations, you can chat about different things. So this is one of the things I really like. If you go to a project, let's go here. Yes. So this not only keeps track of your actual tasks, but you can have notes, you can have subtasks, you can have links in there to special documents. So when we were first starting out and I was trying to offload some of the stuff that was in my brain. I would have a task and I would have links to different videos or whatever, so that somebody who was trying to complete the task had all the information at their fingertips so that they could actually walk through and complete the task without me having to like be standing over their shoulder and training them or something like that. It was kind of a living document. It was really great. As we got a little bit bigger, that started to fall apart a little bit. We needed a more standalone training, kind of a learning management system. I'll talk about that another week. But it's really cool to have all that stuff just accessible and helpful to whoever's going through the projects. And you can leave comments on here and talk about different tasks back and forth. You can keep track of what people are working on and stuff like that. One of the other things I think is really cool about Asana is they make things really fun. So like as you're ticking off projects and, okay, I did that. Every once in a while, you'll have like a flying unicorn go across your screen or a narwhal or something like that. It's really kind of cool. And then like, I like this. This is one of, I think you have to turn this feature on. But if you hold down the tab key and then the letter B, this really special thing happens. I mean, it's just silly. And, you know, work is work enough. It's fun to make things fun once in a while. So that's it. I love Asana. I think it's working really great for us. It's really powerful. It's really flexible. And I hope you like it. I hope you like this video. If you did, please like, comment, and share. If you haven't already, please subscribe. And I'll catch you later.